What's up, guys? Jethro Prime here, and crazy back-to-back recordings wild. We are here about to take on Taya Gardner and her water squad. Hopefully not too bad. That's the big downside to choosing fire, is because water is scary, and I'm sure there's other water users throughout this. I'd be shocked if Mako Tsunami's not in this game. He is in this game. I just scrolled through the list of opponents, and yeah, he's in this game, so yeah, this is gonna be wild. So I'm just gonna hop into it, because why not? Taya, look at Taya is bae. Let's be honest though, Taya is bae as fuck, my dude. Right, absolutely right.
Yugi, here I come!
Taya!
I always wanted to duel against you to see how...
Ah, but don't expect me to take it easy on you, Taya.
Bet you about to get the work.
Of course not. I'll never forgive you if you treat me with kitty gloves.
Okay, let's duel!
I really want to scout her squad. I really hope I get the card on this one. No, damn it. Please choose attack second. Yes, that is so good for us. And there's a light three light monsters? And two wood monsters. She only has one water? What? That throws me off. Okay. So, she got three light monsters. So that's immediately like... Because thunder is strong against light, correct? Yes. So I'm immediately going to pack thunders. And he has nothing, and he doesn't have... She doesn't have any earth monsters. So I'm going to pack these two steel scorpions. And I'm also going to pack Kaminari Kazoo. She does have the wind monster, or the water monster, so I do want to still bring a wind. What's her movement like? It doesn't show here. Fuck. I mean, wood means I bring fire, guaranteed. Gonna bring a flame viper. I'm trying to bring a drill bird. I'll just bring drill bird. Wait, which one? Which is the one that I've used already? Yeah. And then I'll just bring another flame viper. I'll bring both of them. We'll make work of that. Let's do it. That makes things much, much easier, though. I have to be careful with Drillbird because she does have the wood monsters, which are good against me. Perfect. And then this alignment will work nicely. I love that I'm attacking first. So clean.
It's time to start!
Oh Alrighty. Who gives me the most AP? It's not anyone necessarily. Yeek. Oh, my friend just asked me to go get food. I'm sorry, I just started recording.
Gotta think. I can't afford to make a mistake.
What is that? Is that root water? Is that root water?
Here I go.
Alrighty, alrighty, tidy, tidy. Let's get the party started. We are going to... No. I want to... I'm just going to spend my first couple turns summoning. The sooner I get my maxed out shit, the better. Like, I'm all about playing defensively against her just to see what she does. And so I can plan my moves accordingly. She didn't even summon any of her... Gonna move one. Just to immediately end the turn. Right, she's just summoning this turn. She's got. What are those? Okay. I think that's a good placement for right now. Set myself in a good place, see what we can do. Damn, happiness moved so far. Alright. Attack this thing, which is huge. I'm gonna hit this thing hard. I'm gonna hit this thing hard right off the bat. I'm not gonna waste any time. I'm wild. That damage. Early damage. Don't want you in the line of fire. How do these things attack? It moves four but attacks one. Shit, they can double team my scorpion. I made a mistake. Already made a mistake. Crucial mistake. Not entirely. Okay, I can. If I leave this scorp here, I can capitalize on that. I'm gonna when they do attack me. I think that staying in this spot for right now is best. Yeah. That's really bad.
Here I go.
She's gonna take out my scorpion because I made a mistake. She's gonna take out my scorpion because I made a mistake. Oh, it was a stupid mistake too. It was a stupid mistake too. I didn't even look at their movement pattern. And I'm just gonna lose my scorpion turn, her third turn, and her third turn of the match, I'm just gonna lose my scorpion. Because I was dumb. That was a mistake. Huge mistake. That could be huge. Pissed at myself for letting that happen, dude. I'm so mad that I let that happen. I'm not pleased. Alright, so I have to capitalize on this somehow. So if I go right here, I can attack his Skellingel. For big damage. Big damage. Get that shit. Alright, now I can attack his other her other happy lover. For big damage. And since she hasn't moved too far, yeah, I think that's gonna be the play. I can't move past her piece. I'm gonna go ahead and attack with this Flame Viper. I don't remember if we saw his animation, but we're about to. Perfect. So I'm about to take out both of her lights, her other lights this turn. And severely weaken one. Oh, I didn't turn the battle animation off. Well, we're gonna see it twice. Beautiful. It's beautiful that we were able to take out both of those now. That made up for the terribly horrible misplay of our scorpion placement. That made things all much better. Kind of want to just back off a bit with Drollbird. Just move it over here. And then turn. Even if they're able to neuter around me, and like the only thing that can possibly attack me this turn, yeah, is gonna be Skellingel. and that's fine, because I can just attack it. Okay. All the lights are going out. What's up? Oh shit, dude. What's good? Hold up.
Every move is another step in achieving my future.
Okay, so now it's better for... Okay, I can kill this thing with Scorpion. Or with Scorpion. I can kill this with Scorpion. I'm gonna do that. Why does it sound like fucking Christmas hymns? What the fuck? Why is the music right now sounding like fucking Christmas hymns, dude? What the fuck is this insanity? Bruh. I can't... Oh, I can actually... Hold up. I can move here and attack that petite moth. Which is good. Get some clean damage on that thing. That makes my drill bird freer to move around. From here, I can actually go forward and get the root water if it doesn't move too much. And then from here, I can make moves on the petite moths with my flame viper. So we're in a good spot. We're in an okay spot, not a great spot, but like a tolerable spot. That's actually really dumb on his part. Oh no, dude, I think she just gave us the game. I think she just choked hard. Alright, so we're gonna do some finagling. Yeah, we're gonna do some finagling. Bro, we are about to savage on this thing. What the fuck? We gotta go hard. Alright, Kaminari Kazoo's gonna kill this. Flame Viper gonna fly up here. Just straight bops it! Bro, that's crazy. And just straight blows it away. I'll still move Steel Scorpion out, but Steel Scorpion probably is not going to see any action. Now Flame Viper is going to come over here. Gonna chip. Get some nice chip. Nice chip. On the boy. Root Water. And then Drillbird honestly just... comes up here and blows back room water, and we just win. She choked. She choked. 100% she choked. She put herself in position to lose this turn. She literally just put herself directly into position just to lose the game right off bat.
Yep. Like I thought, it's impossible to beat Yugi. You're awesome.
I had that one misplay that I'm really pissed off about, but other than that, I think I played that pretty well, and she totally played freely into my hand. Like, she played that last turn, the AI went full stupid. The dumbest I've ever seen. That was the dumbest I've seen AI play in this game.
Oh no! I lost! on. How about you, Yugi? Did you...
Yes, it was an excellent duel.
Thanks. Yugi?
What is it, Taya?
Well, good luck in the rest of the tournament.
Thank you!
She wants the Yami D. Clear bonus. Nobody gets the level ups. Nice. Clean. Nobody levels up. But we are going to actually cop this root water 100% because we only have one water monster. And I think I want to grab a happy lover. Just because we don't have a, we don't have that many light monsters either. Yeah, so now we at least have two a piece of everything, which is really good. So now we're not limited in what we can bring to games. Huge. The fact that she chose to attack second was really nice too, because then we were able to see... Because I would have loaded my team up with wind monsters, and then realized she has two woods and I would be fucked. And I probably wouldn't have even brought fire monsters at all, to be honest. So we beat Taya. We beat Taya, which is great. Now, that is the second to last person in this stage. The final person for stage one, it's actually Grandpa. That's crazy. That's actually crazy. Alright, so next episode, we're going to be taking on Grandpa Moto. It's going to be a lit-ass matchup because it's Grandpa. It's always Grandpa. Grandpa's the littest character ever. But, yeah, that's awesome. If you guys enjoyed this one, please make sure to leave a like down below and subscribe if you have not already. And with that, I'm Jethro Prime, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.